In order to realize part of the vision of the Bridges curriculum, we need to create more flexible learning paths for our students.
Our goal is basically to transform how we teach at UCSF.
When I first heard about lectures going online, I was definitely skeptical.
I thought it was an interesting concept. I didn't know what it was going to be like, and I assumed that it would just be a video of me talking.
I sort of underestimated it and overestimated it, because first I was like, well, I show up for class and I talk about my stuff, so how different can it be?
People come into this assuming that it's going to be an online lecture, but I really like to think of it as an online lesson. Now we can begin using different types of media, different types of videos, accessing and demonstrating databases and other educational tools that aren't really accessible in a lecture hall format.
I first wanted to try the online lecture by taking my ECG lab and blending videos into the lecture that I normally gave as a live lecture.
Now we're going to look at the augmented voltage leads.
So what we did is we actually videotaped the entire lab and we made 7 video clips. We found a way to get the students in basically 2 places at once. They were simultaneously in the lecture hall and in the lab.
In doing this, I wanted to use apps on the iPad, which is very nice because deep structures, which required some three-dimensional understanding, were much easier to do on these dynamic 3D apps than trying to show a series of slides on the screen.
Sometimes you're in class, you want to pull up a website, then it doesn't work. In this setting, it's guaranteed. You can all load it up. You know it's going to work.
Wherever learning is happening, we want to enable that and transform it for the students. By having a diverse team, instructional designer with a producer, or a media specialist with a PhD educator, helps us see how we can do this in robust ways.
The support from TL has been amazing. I had heard that it was going to be amazing, but it was really beyond what I expected. The staff, Christian and Betsy and Julie, all met. We spent a lot of time in the lab looking at exactly what we were going to do, how we were going to set up the lab.
They're very experienced. I think that resource is vital. And if I'd have done it on my own, it would have been a talking head video and very uninteresting. Getting into the studio was actually nerve-wracking. It was more nerve-wracking than standing in front of 150 students because it was a completely strange environment.
One of the weird divides about filming is that the instructor feels like they're in a black box surrounded by lights and they're talking to nobody. But the students tell us that they actually feel like it's a more intimate personal talk. They've got the instructor making eye contact with them through the video camera. Their instructor is really right up close and the slides are big and crisp and clear.
They were practically stopping me in the hallway saying that they learned so much more, and one individual was saying, I don't know what it is, but when I'm sitting with home, it's like you're there and like you're watching me. And so I said, oh, next time in the video, I should do that.
One of the most important things is that they can go back and study. And there was never any way for any student to go back into lab. Although I was initially skeptical about not having that in-person interaction with the students, I'm not concerned with that anymore because it wasn't one-on-one. It was me with 10 students who had 10 different agendas, and some people got what I was saying and some people didn't.
I also was able to cut it down into small chunks. So instead of doing an hour, trying to get everything into an hour, I could do a series of 10-minute modules about some specific aspect that I wanted to know.
These short, modular, topic-driven online lectures make a lot more sense and are much more portable to our other programs. And it's starting to facilitate new dialogues with our other health professions schools, which is very exciting.
I know people who have been skeptical and they've done it and they've been pleasantly surprised. I think if you are skeptical or you have concerns, you can try one. You can do one lecture, you can do one module and see what it's like.
In this segment, we're going to talk about the determinants of GFR.
Give it a go. You've nothing to lose. And maybe everything to gain.